dear friends, we are now under attack from terrorist organization Hamas. Please pray for our safety.
이스라엘의 메시아닉 공동체와 성도들의 소식과 기도 제목을 전하는 메시아닉 유대인을 위한 기도 시간입니다. 지난 시간에 이어 이스라엘이 가자지구의 무장세력 하마스와 있었던 11일의 전쟁 기간 동안 이스라엘의 메시아닉 공동체가 입은 피해 상황을 전해드리겠습니다. 첫 번째 소식은 테라비브에서 문화사역을 통해 복음을 전하는 메르카즈 행사를 담당하는 빅토리아 투르백의 소식입니다. 수천 발의 로켓이 떨어지는 당시 빅토리아의 집 근방 400m에도 로켓이 떨어졌는데요. 5월 12일 저녁 긴박한 상황을 영상으로 담았고 이후의 상황을 잘 설명해주는 영상도 보내주었습니다. 테라비브 빅토리아 투르백에게서 온 편지를 들어보시죠.
Shalom, shalom dear brothers and sisters in Korea. Thank you for all your prayers. In the last 11 days, we was going through very hard situation in Israel. We was going through tension and war. More than 4,000 rockets were fired on the cities of Israel. Our family is living in Ramat Gan, which is the area of Tel Aviv. And 400 meters from our house was a place that the rocket fell at the house. And for us, it was very hard because we was hearing the alarms, the emergency alarm when we have to run to the safety place, to the bomb shelter. From our apartment to the bomb shelter, it took 1 minute to run. But you have to wear your shoes already and be ready to run. We have two kids, and the youngest, she's 5 years old. She was really scared. It was hard for the kids, but we was praying. We was using a tallit. David was covering us with the tallit, and we was proclaiming from Proverbs. From Proverbs 18, verse 10, we was proclaiming, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous man runs into it, and he is safe. And we was proclaiming that, and we was teaching our kids that the safety place, it's the name of the Lord. And we was praying together and trying to look and feel our safety, receive our safety through Him, in His name, in the name of Yeshua. And thank you for your prayers. We really felt it, and it really helped us to go through those situations.
두 번째 소식은 가자지구에서 가장 가까운 스데롯에서 사역하는 시티 오브 라이프의 마이클 베너 목사에게서 온 편지입니다. 마이클 베너 목사는 5월 10일 로켓 공격이 시작되는 당시 스데롯 근방 장모님이 계시는 아시켈론 지역으로 가족과 여행을 갔다가 돌아오던 중이었습니다. 그런데 갑작스럽게 가자지구로부터 로켓 공격이 시작됐고 도로 중앙에 갇혀 오지도 가지도 못하고 차 밖으로 나갈 수도 없는 상황이었습니다. 2시간 동안 공포에 휩싸여 있던 마이클 베너와 그의 가족의 이야기를 들어보시겠습니다.
Shalom, dear friends. I'm Pastor Michael Biner from City of Life Ministry and the Messianic Congregation and in the city of Sderot, located on the Gaza border, only 3 kilometers from Gaza. And I want to share with you some experience. It was 10th of May in evening hours, 6 p.m., when the terrorists from Gaza proclaimed the war and start shoot to Israeli city. I'm drive from Ashkelon to city of Sderot, and normally this way take about 25 minutes. This time it took about 2.5 hours. Terrorists from Gaza try shoot close to this road and kill people who is drive, and army took us to other way, and it was strong traffic. We drive really slowly, and a rain of rockets from Gaza. When you drive in the ways, in the roads, between the cities, you not have bomb shelters, you can't have sirens, and what you do? You need come out from your car and fall down to protect yourself, or you continue to drive with every people, because in cities you have boom shelters, in cities you have some hiding place, you have sirens. So when I come to my home after this really hard driving, I find my wife and my small boys, two boys in age 9 and 8, at the boom shelter, sit all the time, because the sirens in city of Sderot was one after next, and about 10 or 20 minutes between the sirens during all the evening, all the night, we not sleep normal, children awake every time. And 4 a.m. when the children was really tired, my youngest son asked me, Papa, I'm really tired, what we need to do? I'm asking him, if you're afraid, they said, no, I'm not afraid. I know God keep us and put angels to protect us, and we pray with him. And during few hours from 4 a.m. to 10 a.m., it was no sirens in Sderot. They just shoot other cities. At this time, our children sleep. And now I stay near to the building, to the house, regular house, how you see, when the rocket exploded in the boom shelter. It's happened here, when you see the flag of Israel. The terrorists from Gaza, they used really strong rocket, not normal, they shoot to city of Sderot. And the rocket come through the strong metal window, and glass window explode, and unfortunately, small boy was killed. Also other people was killed in Israel during these 11 days. Just we know the situation could be more bad. And continue to pray now. Pray and ask peace to Jerusalem and ask peace to Israel. We know God protect us and release the angel to keep the cities of Israel because your prayer. So thank you so much for standing with us for prayers and intercess day and night. God of Israel bless you. From City of Sderot, Israel.
마지막 소식은 이스라엘 북부 알리아 리턴 센터에서 온 소식인데요. 알리아 리턴 센터의 디렉터 하임 메일스피는 5월 11일 저녁 이스라엘의 남부 긴급 사령부로부터 한 통의 전화를 받았습니다. 전화의 내용은 혹시 이번 전쟁으로부터 피해를 입은 가정을 도와줄 수 있겠냐는 요청이었고, 알리아 리턴 센터는 곧바로 요청에 동의해 대피소 없이 공포에서 떨고 있는 가정에 갈릴리의 평안을 느낄 수 있는 공간을 제공하였습니다.
Shalom, friends. Thank you for your prayers from around the world. Israel is in a state of national emergency. Even the National Guard has been called in as over 1,000 rockets have been fired from Gaza in the last 24 hours. The IDF, the Israel Air Force, are making a firm surgical strike retaliation. Israel found out that Al-Aqsa Mosque was again being used as a place to stockpile rocks to be hurled on Jewish people who would come to pray and celebrate Jerusalem Day. So the government said no Jewish person should be allowed to go pray on the Temple Mount. I think that was a mistake. But the police anyway had to go and intervene to stop the Muslim rioters who were becoming violent there. And sadly, some Israeli Arab citizens participated in some of these riots. This is a cause of great concern. Never before have there been so many rockets pummeling the entire country all at once like this, even shutting down Ben Gurion Airport. But we as a charity are ready. We're prepared to help those families under the heaviest of the rocket barrages. Even the Southern Emergency Command has contacted our charity last night and asked the Aliyah Return Center if we're able to provide aid and housing for the families under the heaviest rocket fire. We agreed. All last night we began to receive calls from families who are wanting to come. Let's welcome them in warm hospitality in the Galilee, provide them food and shelter. Thank you for your prayers.
이스라엘은 하나님의 눈동자이며 언약의 성취입니다. 이스라엘이 전능하신 하나님의 그늘 아래 보호받을 수 있도록 기도해 주십시오. 마태복음 6장 33절. 그런즉 너희는 먼저 그의 나라와 그의 의를 구하라. 그리하면 이 모든 것을 너희에게 더하시리라. 이번 로켓 공격으로 인해 피해를 입은 메시안이 유대인 가정과 공동체들이 속히 피해가 복구될 수 있도록 기도해 주십시오. 수천 발의 로켓으로 인해 정신적, 육체적 스트레스에 따른 트라우마가 있습니다. 예수아의 치유의 손길로 회복될 수 있도록 기도해 주십시오. 특별히 로켓 공격으로 인해 아이들의 상처가 너무 깊습니다. 아이들의 깊게 패인 상처가 예수아의 능력으로 새 살이 돋아나고 후유증 없이 치유받을 수 있도록 기도해 주십시오. 어려운 상황이지만 공동체가 지역 사회를 위해 섬기고 있습니다. 이때 예수아의 복음과 사랑이 흘러갈 수 있도록 기도해 주십시오. 이스라엘의 회복을 위하여 메시아닉 유대인을 위해 항상 함께 기도해 주시는 시청자 여러분 감사합니다.